So let's look at the first sentence that we have. This sentence has one blank. Reading. They work hard not because of the blank, but because of their inner urge. So I understand that the context itself, there is a contrast, right? They work hard not because of the, there is something, but because of their inner urge. So let's look at our options. Option 1, desire. Option 2, drive. Option 3, energy. Option 4, incentive. And option 5, motivation. And we also have a clue word in the context. Are you able to identify the clue word? The clue word is nothing but inner urge. That's our clue word. Right? So, what do you understand by inner urge? Inner urge means nothing but desire, the motivation, the zeal or the energy for you to do something. You know, there is some sort of a drive. So, if you look at it, from my options, there are four words that are synonym with inner urge, which is option 1, option 2, option 3 and option 5. The only word that is left out is incentive. Now, let's look at the context. They work hard not because of the incentive, but because of their inner urge. They are not looking at some sort of, a reward or money or some sort of expectation, but they are working only because, you know, they are self-motivated. You know, there's some sort of inner urge or desire. They love what they're doing, and that's why they, work hard. So we understand from the given clue word, inner urge, so we know that we have to look at the answer option has to be a word that is opposite in meaning to inner urge. And we've already identified four synonyms with inner urge from the options. So for the first sentence, our answer is incentive. They work hard not because of the incentive, but because of their inner urge. Let's go ahead and write that down. Let's move on to our second sentence. His blank background has made him so docile. All right. Now, in the second sentence, there is another word that is acting as a clue word, which is nothing but docile. Right? Docile comes from the word domestic. Okay. So, docile is somebody who's being very timid. Not just timid, rather would be shy, but we're talking about somebody who's very meek. Right? Let's look at our answer options. We have option 1, famous, option 2, lucrative, option 3, rich, option 4, advanced, option 5, humble. Now, are there any words that you probably don't understand the meaning of? Lucrative, profitable, right? So let's fall back. So we've identified our clue word docile. We understand what that means. And this is basically a synonym clue word, right? There is another word in the context helping you identify the answer option. So his what background has made him so docile? So I have to look for a word that brings in the same meaning as docile, because docile is backing up the answer option, right? Having said that, from our options, we know that the answer is option 5, humble, somebody who's meek, somebody who, is teachable. Right? Somebody who understands what it takes to do something. So, famous, lucrative, rich, advanced in this context does not fit the bill. So, we've identified the answer option as 5 for the second sentence. Let's go ahead and put that down. Third sentence. It is dash for everyone to abide by the laws of the land. Alright? So, again, are you able to identify the clue word from the context? Yes, abide, right? Something that has to be followed, strictly followed, adhered to. So, let's look at our options. Expected, option 1, option 2, obligatory, option 3, meant, option 4, optional, option 5, recommended. Okay, so let's see what are we looking at. From the given options, which is the word that is bringing in the meaning of something that must be done, right? An obligation, which is nothing but the second option, obligatory. Some of you might come back and say, what about expected, right? When I use expected, you normally follow it with a preposition to and not for. You know, he is expected to do this. What was expected of you, right? That's another context where of as a preposition is following expected. So based on the context, normally you would either have to or of following expected and not for. So having said that, the answer option for sentence 3 is obligatory. It is obligatory, it is necessary, it is a must that everyone needs to abide by the laws of the land. Okay, so let's go ahead and put that down. Let's move on to our fourth sentence. Dash, he is a hard worker. His quality of work is not of a desirable level. What are my options? Option 1, despite. Option 2, because. Option 3, although. Option 4, somehow. Option 5, however. Okay, so in this sentence again, we have a antonym hint word, which is not. Right? Not. Dash, he is a hard worker. His quality of work is not of a desirable level. So basically, I need to look at, from the options, given options, which is the word that is giving me, an antonym, a contrast, a hint. Is it despite? Is it because? It is although? Is it although? Is it somehow? Or is it however? Let's look at our options. Despite means in spite of, right? However, I would not be able to grammatically fit this word in the context, because if I have to use despite, I have to say despite him being a hard worker. We don't say despite he is a hard worker, which is incorrect as a sentence construction. So I rule out option 1. Because he is a hard worker, his quality of work is not of a desirable level. Now because is a cause hint word, right? Giving me the reason. So if he is a hard worker, then his work should be of a desirable level, but it says it's not of a desirable level, so option 2 is out. Although means even though, right? Although he is a hard worker, his quality of work is not of a desirable level. So you expect his work to be of a desirable level because he is a hard worker, but it's not. So a contrast clue word here is although, which fits the bill. Somehow he is a hard worker, his quality of work, it's not a logical fit. However, he is a hard worker. Again, however brings in the meaning of nevertheless. It's not the right fit in this context. So our option is option 3. Although he is a hard worker, complementing the hint word, the antonym hint word not, and although is a contrast hint word as well. So let's go ahead and make that change. Although he is a hard worker, his quality of work is not of a desirable level. Let's move to our next blank. In spite of repeated instructions, he dashed the same mistakes. Let's look at our options. Option 1, commits. Option 2, detects. Option 3, corrects. Option 4, imitates. Option 5, exhibits. Alright. Again, we have in spite of, right, which is a contrast hint word. Repeated instructions, he dashed the same mistakes. So again, we're looking at we understand the context, right? The sentence is conveying the meaning that in spite of providing repeated instructions, this person continues to do the same mistakes. So which option gives me that meaning? Commits, option 1. Not detects, not corrects, not imitates, and not exhibits, definitely. All these four words are not the right vocabulary fit in this context, right? He's not detecting anything, he's not identifying anything. He's definitely not correcting it because he is the one who is doing the mistakes. He's not imitating anybody and it's not a show that he's exhibiting, right? So he commits. It's something that he does. So the answer is option 1. Moving on to our sixth sentence. Rohit dash a huge library and has a large collection of books in it. Option 1, wants. Option 2, has. Option 3, wanted. Option 4, had, and option 5, needs. Now, looking at the context, we're talking about something that he already has, right? And it's talking about what he has in it also. So, I can automatically eliminate option 1, option 3, and option 5. Because the general tense in the sentence is present tense, I can also eliminate option 4, which is had, which is the past tense verb, right? So, our answer option is Rohit has a huge library and has a large collection of books in it. You already have the clue word in the context, which is the simple present tense has, right? So let's make that correction. Moving on to our seventh sentence. Rachna liked her room to be exactly the way she left it, and she would dash allow anyone to touch her things. So what is the context conveying to us? It says what its meaning is, that, you know, Rachna basically doesn't like anybody to touch her things. She likes it just the way it is. So let's look at our options. Always, sometimes, willing, never, certainly. So we know that we need a negative word. And where is that coming from? It says she would dash allow anyone to touch her things. So if somebody likes their room to be just the way they've left it, obviously we're looking at a negative word. From the options, the negative word, the only negative option is option 4, never. All the other words, always, sometimes, willing, certainly, are positive words, right? So looking at the context again, we know that our option is 4, never. Rachna liked her room to be exactly the way she left it, and she would never allow anyone to touch her things. Let's go ahead and fill that blank. Moving on to our eighth sentence. Elephants are the largest living land animals dash earth today. Let's look at our options. Option 1, in. Option 2, and. Option 3, on. Option 4, like. And option 5, at. So we have a mix of prepositions and a conjunction as options. So let's look at what would be the right fit. We're talking about these land animals present on the surface of the earth, right? So on the surface of, the preposition that gives you that meaning is option 3, on, right? When we say in as a preposition is normally used to talk about in an enclosed area, in a space, in a city, in a country. Right? So, in would not be the best fit here. Elephants are the largest living animals, land animals, and earth today. Illogical. Elephants are the largest living land animals like earth today. Again, illogical. Elephants are the largest living land animals at earth today. Again, illogical, because at, again, as a preposition, brings in a specific location, but we're widely talking about earth here, and we're talking about on the surface of. So, the right preposition that'll fit the blank is on. Let's go ahead and fill the blank. Our ninth sentence. Josephine was elated because the doctor confirmed the news dash her pregnancy. So we understand the context is talking about whose pregnancy? Josephine's pregnancy, right? The pregnancy is hers, right? Now, so basically from the options, we need to look at a word that brings in the meaning of possession, right? Let's look at our options. Option 1, like. Option 2, off. Option 3, with. Option 4, after. And option 5, in. We know from the given prepositions, what is our option? Off. Right? What is the answer? Off. Josephine was elated because the doctor confirmed the news of her pregnancy. Off is a preposition that brings in the meaning of belonging, possession. Right? Not with. With, again, talks about accompanying. Not after, illogical fit. And not definitely in, and like, right? So our answer option is 2, off. Let's fill that blank. Moving on to our 10th sentence. It dash been estimated that there may be many millions of species of plants, insects, and microorganisms still undiscovered in tropical rainforests. Now, this is an easy, pretty easy options if you look at it, the sentence itself, because you have been estimated, you know, which is a perfect tense, right? So you just have to look at what would be the right option to fall in with this particular form. Is it have? Is it will? Is it should? Is it has? Or is it shall? I know from my structure, you know, with been estimated being the clue, it either has to be have or has. I can automatically eliminate option 2, 3, and 5. Will, should, and shall. Right? Will be an estimated, should be an estimated, shall be an estimated, incorrect. Because we know modals. Will, should, and shall are modals. And modals are usually followed by the base form, which is nothing but the first verb. Right? Remember, verbs we have the present tense, we have the past tense, and then we have the past participle, right? So when I have modals, they usually are followed with the base verb, the first verb. So here, because it's it, we're talking about a singular subject, the option has to be option 4, has and not have, right? So let's fill that blank. So it has been estimated that there may be many millions of species of plants, insects and microorganisms still undiscovered in tropical rainforests.